I want to show you how you can create consolidated financial statements in Dynamics 365 Business Central. It's fairly easy to do. So what I did for this demonstration is I set up a holding company. This is going to be my consolidating company. It's not an operating company, it's just a consolidating company. I can also put into this eliminating entries if I need to. And you can see from this format here that I've got two operating companies I'm rolling up and I'm consolidating up to North America Holdings. There's a few built-in reporting tools I want to show you. There's two trial balances we'll take a look at, and then we'll look at account schedules, how you can set that up to get information on consolidated results, and also drill down and analyze those results. Right now I'm logged into the holding company. And I look at my business unit screen, you can see I've got two operating companies rolling up to that, AM Industrial and Cronus. I also entered one elimination entry into the holding company. You can see that here. This eliminates a portion of an intercompany sale. And I put that in the holding company and posted it. Once I'm ready to do the consolidation, I can do it from the business unit screen, and it's easy to do. All I need to do is go to Actions, and then Run Consolidation. It's going to run it for a period of time, and then I can run a consolidated trial balance at the end of this process. So let's put some dates in. Here's the consolidated trial balance. You can see account by account, I've got the individual operating companies identified over here. If I scroll down a little bit, I can see the elimination entry I entered for this consolidation. Now this was entered in the holding company and it was just a regular journal entry. And here's another version of the trial balance that you might like. This version shows the consolidating company in columns and also has a column for eliminations. Let's see what you can do with account schedules. Account schedules is built into Business Central. So I created one here for consolidated income statements. Let's take a look at that. Let's open it up. This is the row format I created for the consolidation. And all I did was import the chart of accounts from the holding company, and I've got it right here. It automatically puts in the totals and the subtotals. Let's take a look at the column layout that I set up for this. Here's the column layout. I've added the two operating companies. You can see those here. I totaled them. So if I want to, I can just print this as a regular account schedule report. But what I really like is the ability to drill down and find information about the consolidation. And I can do that if I go to the overview. So let's go to Process, Overview. And it brings up this matrix. So what's nice about this matrix is you can see I've got the different operating companies in different columns here. I can drill down, I can see the underlying entries if I want to. So I'll just drill down here. I've got a familiar drill down ability here. Look at the underlying transactions. I can go to the account. In this case, it's income account. Look at the ledger entries. I'll see all the ledger entries that roll up to make this consolidated entity and also to make the individual operating entities. You can see that here. But also what's really handy is I can download this into Excel easily. So let's do that. It creates this workbook, and what I can do from here is use Excel formatting to give me exactly the statement look I want. And then I can also come back later and I can refresh this existing spreadsheet. It's easy to do. So let's just put a simple graph on here. I'll identify the data that I want in the graph and then just insert the graph. I can certainly add more formatting if I want to, and then I can just save this as a template. So the next time I run the account schedules and the overview, I can download it into that template. This has been a quick view of how you can create consolidated financial statements in Dynamics 365 Business Central. I showed you how I set up the consolidation company and the business units that feed into it. We looked at one elimination entry, we ran the consolidation, and looked at two different trial balance reports. And then looked at account schedules for not only the reporting aspect of it, but for the analysis view of it.